Brothers and sisters, we are coming to the end of the Hijra calendar. Dhilhijja month is coming to end. Today is the last Friday of the lunar month, the lunar calendar. The new Hijra year will start after a couple of days. Let us today, we take some lesson. We don't celebrate. There is no celebration in Islam for a new year. 31st night to celebrate by committing some munkar and welcoming the new year. In Islam, the concept is we do our self-account, self-criticism. How was the last month, last year? What we are getting from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? And what is our commitment for the new year? As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, why he changes all these? He said in the Quran, Surah 25, Ayat 62, يُقَلِّبُ اللَّهُ اللَّيْلَ وَالنَّهَارِ إِنَّ فِي ذَلِكَ الْعِبْرَةَ لِأُولِي الْأَبْصَارِ. Allah alternates the night and the day. Indeed, in that is a lesson for those who have a vision, who can realize, who have their sense to utilize. Why this? Morning is coming, sun is rising. When sun rises, no doubt it will set. When we are born, no doubt we will be dying. So every day comes and comes to finish, to end. This way this life will come to end one day. How soon? What is our preparation for that? This is a reminder after the end of the day, after the end of the month, end of the week, end of the year. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said also in the Quran, وَهُوَ الَّذِي جَعَلَ اللَّيْلَ وَالنَّهَارَ لِخِلْفَةً لِمَنْ أَرَادَ أَنْ يَذَّكَّرَ أَوْ أَرَادَ شُكُورًا. And it is He who has made the night and the day in succession for whoever desires to remember or desires gratitude. To be grateful to Allah for all this ni'mah and to realize how much shortcoming we had, how much we failed to comply with the command of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Who is happy here if we ask each other? Who is satisfied from the last years, all these actions, my life, all these acts, all these actions, all these works, all these deeds, that I am happy, I am satisfied, if I go to Allah, I'll be okay to answer, give the account of whole past years on, forget about all other past years. Just last year, just this year, which we are coming to finish. Who is satisfied to say, I have no worry for that, I'm okay, I'll be managing it? None of us. Everybody will regret. No, I could be doing better. I did so much mistakes. I have committed so much sins. I have missed so much opportunities to ask Allah forgiveness. Everybody will regret. Today we don't realize it. One day we'll be realizing. We'll be crying to Allah. We'll be screaming to Allah. Allah, give me a chance to go back, to do something good. I came with empty hands. I didn't realize, oh Allah, send me back. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will never send us back. It is for once. So if we ask why we couldn't do, let us ask ourselves, because I was busy with many things. Busy with what? The most of the things we summarize, this dunya and its attraction, its fitna, its trial, made us so busy. This is the dunya. The dunya, Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam warned us that this dunya is very sweet, okay? And this dunya is very green, okay? And it is very attractive. He said, this dunya, this world is sweet and green, alluring. And verily, Allah is making you to succeed each other, generations after generations, coming to this world, in order to see how you act. So beware of this world and beware of women. Two things he mentioned. The this world, the wealth, the money, the worldly success, the women, two things. How it is big trial and fitna? We don't need so many evidences and details, we know. And in another hadith, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, من كان همه الآخرة جمع الله شمله وجعل غناه في قلبه وأعطته الدنيا وهي راغمة ومن كانت نيته الدنيا فرق الله عليه ضيعته وجعل فقره بين عينيه ولم يأته من الدنيا إلا ما كتب له. He said, so whoever his intention and worry is only this the akhirah, he's always occupied with the thought of akhirah, always aware, always worried what will happen in akhirah, then Allah will make his all affairs are well organized, having less trouble in his life. And Allah will make him, he's rich in his heart. He's rich. He's not always complaining, oh, I didn't have this, I want that, I want this. He's always ever satisfied with what Allah has given him as sustenance. And dunya will come to him, what Allah has already allocated for him. That will come to him. That is forced, obliged to come to him. He'll not miss it, whatever he's supposed to get. And whoever is other way, his all intention, all worry is about this dunya, how to improve it, how to get it more. And about akhirah, he's totally heedless. He's never worried. Then Allah will make his all affairs are disorganized. Problem after another, one after another. And he'll be never have self-sufficiency in his mind. Always complaining of missing and losing to get more and more. More greed will occupy him. And he will not get from the dunya except what is decided by Allah for him. Nothing will get more than that. Ali radiallahu anhu, his son-in-law and the fourth khalif, a great companion who understands the deen from the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he said us, ارتحلت الدنيا مدبرة وارتحلت الآخرة مقبلة ولكل واحدة منهما بنون فكونوا من أبناء الآخرة ولا تكونوا من أبناء الدنيا فإن اليوم عمل ولا حساب وغدا حساب ولا عمل. The dunya, this world, is turned away from us. It started going, living from us. But from the day we are born, we are heading to our grave one day, month, year after another. And the akhirah is coming to us. It has started a journey to come to us. And for every one of them, there are children. Verily, the dunya is coming to an end, and the akhirah is coming to a beginning. And they both have children. Both have its followers, its people. So be children of the akhirah, and don't be children of the dunya. For verily, today there is action with no account. Today we have this freedom of action, no account. And tomorrow there is account with no action. There is no opportunity. There is no chance to come back. People will be realizing, regretting tomorrow when standing in front of Allah, oh Allah, I came with empty hand. I'm very poor in terms of my righteous deed. Well, I never realized that is the reality. Well, Allah, could you send me back? So I can do something and come back with something. No chance will be given to him. This is the warning Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala making us today here. So when we say goodbye to one year and we welcome another year, we don't need to celebrate the way people do, having a party and doing some kind of munkar, committing some more sins. No, a Muslim will not celebrate at all. Rather, will take his own account, sitting down, having self-criticism. How we can improve? What we did between us and Allah? what is our the tawheed deserve from us? What about our salah? How many of us prayed regularly in jama'ah? How many of missed miqada salah one after another, only praying jum'ah every day missing? How many have prayed further in time? What about the Quran reciting every day? How much I did last year? How much I did between me and other people in terms of my transaction, dealing, behavior? How many people I hurt? I denied the right of the people. The suffering people of the Ummah, how much we did? 1 year is gone, going from our brothers in Syria and the sisters. What is their suffering when it comes to the end? What is my contribution towards that? Let us think at all these and ask Allah tawfiq wa Allah next year, make me one good servant of you. Give me tawfiq that I become your obedient servant. Allah, make me stronger in my iman and action. Allah, make my shaitan away from me. All this we need to pray to Allah rather than making a party and celebrating. I know, alhamdulillah, most of the Arabs will be not doing so. But in many other culture, a Gregorian calendar to finish and to welcome New Year, the New Year parties. Even in Bengali culture, this New Year, the festival, and all this munkar, this kind of program is a satanic path. We must come away from this. We must take our own account. وَبِاللَّهِ التَّوْفِيقِ بَارَكَ اللَّهُ لِي وَلَكُمْ فِي الْقُرْآنِ الْعَظِيمِ ونفعني وإياكم بما فيه من الآيات والذكر الحكيم وأقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم ولسائر المسلمين من كل ذنب فاستغفروه وتوبوا إليه إنه هو الغفور الرحيم. إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن سيدنا محمدا عبده ورسوله اللهم صل وسلم وبارك على محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه وأتباعه ومن دعا بدعوته إلى يوم الدين. أما بعد، عباد الله، اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. واعلموا أن أحسن الحديث كتاب الله وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم وشر الأمور محدثاتها وكل محدثة بدعة وكل بدعة ضلالة وكل ضلالة في النار. وعليكم بالجماعة فإن يد الله مع الجماعة ومن شد في النار. وصلوا على البشير النذير إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما. اللهم صل وسلم وبارك على محمد. رضى الله عن الأربعة الخلفاء الراشدين المهديين الذين قضوا بالحق وبه كانوا يعدلون، أبي بكر، عمر، عثمان، علي، وعن سائر أصحاب نبيك محمد أجمعين، وعن الذين يتبعونهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين، وعنا معهم برحمتك ومنك وكرمك وإحسانك يا رب العالمين. ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار. اللهم أعنا على ذكرك وشكرك وحسن عبادتك. اللهم إنا نسألك موجبات رحمتك وعزائم مغفرتك والسلامة من كل إثم والغنيمة من كل بر والفوز بالجنة والنجاة من النار. اللهم أت نفوسنا تقواها وزكها، أنت خير من زكاها، أنت وليها ومولاها. اللهم إنا نسألك العفو والعافية في الدين والدنيا والآخرة. توفنا مسلمين وألحقنا بالصالحين، توفنا وأنت راض عنا يا أرحم الراحمين. اللهم اشف مرضانا واغفر موتانا وارحمنا يا رب العالمين. اللهم انصر عبادك المستضعفين في كل مكان. اللهم انصر إخوان المستضعفين في سوريا وفي سائر بلادك يا رب العالمين. اللهم انصرهم بنصرك المبين. اللهم ثبت أقدامهم. اللهم زلزل تحت أقدام أعدائهم الذين يحاربون دينك ويقاتلون أولياءك. اللهم خذهم أخذ عزيز مقتدر. اللهم أنزل عليهم بأسك الذي لا ترده عن القوم المجرمين. اللهم إنا نجعلك في نحورهم ونعوذ بك من شرورهم. عباد الله، اذكروا الله يذكركم واشكروه يزدكم ولذكر الله أكبر. والله يعلم ما تسمعون. وأقم الصلاة.